Hello, this is Matt Worley, and this video will cover Lucity 2.0 for iPad and iPhone, and it will specifically look at the map and finding and working with assets in the map. So to start with, we're going to open the map. From the dashboard, we're going to tap on the map button in the upper right. And once the map loads, it loads to an extent that I had saved before, and you see a lot of different assets features showing here in the map. So there are three different tools we use to work with assets or features in the map. And those three tools are down here at the bottom on the right. So the first one is this blue circle with an eye in the middle, and that is an identify tool, which allows us to tap on an asset and then for the map to tell us what that asset is. And then we can do a few things with it. The second one is this icon that looks like binoculars. And that is a find asset tool. So it allows us to enter the common ID for the asset and have it find it in the map for us. And then the third one is this light blue and white box with an arrow. And that is a select tool. So it allows us to select one or more. So it allows us to select multiple assets and then do something with all those assets. So we'll work through those individually one by one. The first one we'll look at is the identify, so that's this blue icon. And if we tap that, you'll see that it kind of highlights it so we know that it's enabled. And then if I go up here and tap on an asset in the map, so I'm going to actually tap on this asset, which is, it's actually a manhole. The symbology looks like kind of like a white daisy with a yellow center, but it's actually a manhole. So I'm going to tap on that. And when I do that, you'll notice that it actually highlighted a pipe. It actually highlighted a main rather than the manhole. And that's because anytime I tap on the map, if I tap on a place where there might be several assets underneath my tap point, it'll actually find all of them. So it actually highlighted this one. But in this dialog that opened, if I use this arrow key here, I can then see a list of the ones that are underneath my tap point. And it doesn't show my manhole, so I'm not sure why that happened, but that's okay. We'll just go with this gravity main. And so this gravity main is the one highlighted, and you also notice that when it highlighted it, it opened a pane over here on the right. And this pane gives us some attributes of this feature in the map, and you might have to scroll to see all of them if there's more than will show in this screen. But those are available, and then at the bottom, there are several tools. So this first tool down here at the bottom is one we're familiar with from other places in the application. It's the Create Work Order button. And so if I create a work order from here, it's going to create a work order. It's going to pull whatever work order category makes sense for this feature type and populate it into the category field on the work order, and then it's going to add an asset record to the work order for this particular asset. So we'll just show that really quickly here. If I tap on that work order button, it's going to open a new work order form. You see it populated in as force mains, even though in the map it showed gravity mains, so there must be something funky in my data. But this is the new work order form, and if I go up and open the children, you'll see that that asset is showing here, and it's that asset is the one that I have identified in the map. So you'll also notice that, you know, I showed you a moment ago, this arrow shows that I actually have three mains selected here. And so those are actually showing in this pane as well. This is one of three. So I can actually just use a swipe and get to the next one, and when I do, it'll change the attributes, and it'll also change the one that's plotted in the map. Then I can swipe to the next one, and it'll go to the next one. So whatever points are plotted when you do that identify, not only will they show up in your drop-down here, but they'll also show up in the pane here, and you can swipe around to get between them. So the second tool besides the create work order is this create request. That's kind of obvious. It creates a new request on this asset, adding the asset to the request. The third one is create inspection, And if this kind of feature has more than one inspection type, then when I tap that, it'll actually give me a list of various inspections I can run on this particular asset. And so then I can tap that and it'll create an inspection of that type. The fourth button is the open form button. So what that does is then it will open the record in Lucity for this asset. And that will allow you, I'll just show you on this one, if I open that up, it actually opens the inventory form so that I can change information in here if I need to. And backing out one layer using the back button here in iOS takes me right back where I was. The fifth tool down here at the bottom is the relationships button. So if I tap on that, it's going to show me that I have this one pipe here. I have a TV inspection, a line lambing, a building inspection, four work orders, and a template all set up on this particular asset. So that's the identify tool. And you'll see fairly shortly here that the same pane and the same functionality works kind of throughout the app in various ways. So anytime I'm in the map and I'm done with whatever I'm doing, if I go up here to the menu in the upper right and clear graphics, it'll just kind of clear out the map for me so that I can start again. So the next tool we'll look at is this find asset tool down here, the binoculars. And if I tap on that, again, it'll enable it and it'll open up this pane. And it asks me which service I want to search in. So on this map, I have a park and a sewer service, and I want to look in the sewer service for a particular feature. So then it asks me the feature type, which is the layer in the map. And I want to look again for a gravity main. And then it asks for the common name or the common ID. So if I just type in the value 1,000, I know that there's a pipe with the common ID of 1,000, so it's going to find it. But you'll also notice that this search supports the percent symbol as a partial match. So I could type in 100 with a percent, and it would find all of those 1000 through 1009. I'm not going to do that, but that's certainly a possibility here. If you're not exactly sure which pipe you're looking for, or if you want to find a range of them. And then tapping the find, and it will actually then move the map to where that asset is and plot that so that I can see it here. And again, open that same pane. And in that same pane, we have the same tools. Create work order, create request, create inspection, open the record, and get to relationships. So that is the find. And the very last one then, I'm going to zoom my map out here a little bit so that I can get a few more assets to work with. This last tool then is a select tool, and it allows us to select one or multiple assets. So if I enable that, you're going to notice that again I get the same dialog where it asks me what service and what feature type. So I'm going to again choose sewer. This time I'm actually going to choose structures, which is this one here, so that I can select manholes. And then I go into select mode. And when I do that, it opens this pane over here on the right. And basically this pane collects a list of the ones that I've chosen to select from my map. So I'm just going to start here with this one right here. And so I'm going to tap on that. And when I tap on that, it's going to, you can see it changed it to a plotted one and it put that number in the list. And then I'm going to go down and select this one. And when I do that, it will select that one and put it in the list as well. And I'm just going to go through here and select several. And you're going to notice as I do this, that it selects and adds them to my list. So now I have five manholes all showing in my list. And at this point, the tools are just as you would expect. Down here at the bottom, you have create work order. If I create a work order, what it's going to do is create one work order and put all five of these assets on that one work order. Or the create request will create five requests, one request each for each of these assets, because requests can only be tied to one asset. Or inspections, and in this case, again, it would create five different inspections, one inspection each for these assets. So one of the things that we've added recently to the application is the ability to select assets rather than tapping on them, to select them using a polygon. Before I show you that, I just want to note that when you create a work order from these assets and it puts all of these assets on your work order, it will put these assets on that work order in the order that you have them listed here. So this would be the first asset, this would be the second asset, this would be the third asset. That also applies when you create from a polygon. But the polygon doesn't allow you to order them, it just puts them in this list in some random order. So if you're trying to get a specific order, you'll need to use this tap one by one so that you get it in the order that you want it. But using the polygon can create a lot, or can select a lot of assets very quickly. So we'll show that. And in iOS, as with a lot of things, iOS allows you to swipe to delete. So I'm going to tap on this and delete this. And I'm just going to go through and delete all five of these from my list so that I can now show you how the polygon select works. So I'm in the same place here, and down here next to my work order, I've got this little thing that looks like a dark gray polygon. If I select that, it turns orange, and now I'm able to select using a square. And in iOS, we tap the points around the square. So I'm going to first tap up here in this corner. And see that point showed up there, and then I'm going to tap down here in this corner. See, it drew a line, and now I'm going to tap over here, and I'm going to finish my box by tapping up here in this corner. And once I've done that, then it's going to select all the manholes that were inside the box I just drew, and you see it put them all in this list. But this list isn't in any particular order, it just took all these and put them in a list. So it'll still create the work order the same way, and it'll put them on the work order in this order, but this may not be the order that you would want to work on them in. So just keep that in mind. But again, same functionality here. You can create a work order request or inspections for these. It's just a different way of selecting the assets. So those are the three tools that allow you to select and work with assets. The other tools about locations, we talked about in an earlier video, and the next videos we'll talk about the show and map functionality.